fallen hero with a long sword. This is interesting terrain. There's a lot of elevation change, which is really good for killing guys. I think what we want to do is retreat up. I think. I assume there's a necro here, right? There's the necro haste buff. Is there geist as well, or just... I didn't actually see geist. Maybe it's just the necro. With 20 zombies who are pretty heavily armored. Two fallen heroes. Necro just buffed again. We should really see where this guy goes. He might be able to catch somebody. Yeah, exactly. So it's better this way we don't remove everybody. I don't want to fight this here. Didn't kill it. It's very disappointing. He's gonna let the other zombies close. I can disarm it. But we're now setting up in this position, which is not where I want to be fighting. I don't really care about the positioning. It's just I care about Filthy being trapped against the brother there. Against the zombie, rather. Oh, there are guys. Ah, fuck. This is getting worse by the moment. I think we can still retreat there. This zombie traps that player, but this player has pretty good melee defense, so we can back up with that. Brother, not player, excuse me. So, just straight back and up, I think. I don't know how that guy got there. Wasn't there an elevation change that I just... I'm not entirely certain what the fuck just happened there. Oh, also, what happened to my bannerman? Why didn't he get to move? I skip him twice? Oh, fuck me, dude. Not been going how I wanted this to go. Actually looking pretty bad. Not an efficient use of our stamina. The geists are going to be in position in a moment. We don't really have an answer to them right now. This looks fucking terrible for me. See, I guess we can get the geist dead, maybe. That's decent. Two of them just moved into whip position. That was fucking bullshit. He runs up there with acceleration, doesn't take his triple attack here to block the guy from flanking the necro. Seriously, like, what are these fucking 10,000 IQ plays from zombies all of a sudden? Like, is anyone else, like, just totally shocked by that move? I not enough stam for one? That's terrible. It's so bullshit. Like, it leaves a swordsman's zone of control to run up 6 elevation levels to block the mace. He's not even closer. It's just like, it literally is. They're preventing you from getting to the dude now, which is horseshit. He needs to be able to double swing and he can't. We will kill that, but it's gonna take forever. I don't know, chat. This is looking sketchy. Dude, he just attacked me 6 times. Buff the one. I mean, that's, I guess, fine. Ain't fine long term though. Can't even get away from this. What? Why? What is this insanity? Dude, come on. Kind of annoying. It's not different AI. It's been a change somewhere in how that reacts. This is very different behavior than Necro Guards. We experienced this yesterday too. So we can no longer rally and we don't have recover here. I think we're still in this for the moment. Certainly not in good shape. The fact that Geist died is something. This guy breaking is super bad. We need to get his resolve up. It'd be nice if, you know, he gained a resolve level from killing something. Because now when this resurrects, there's a chance he just doesn't get that. There's one more tile he can be moved next to as well. Is that one randomly named? No, that's the guy we died. That's our brother who died. It's like I don't want to kill one of the... I want to kill the zombies, but I don't want to kill... Yeah, fuck this. Like, we're going to get stuck here forever because they're like ultra guardians of any brother who's not with the pack. So you're just forced to bring archers then. It's annoying. Yeah, okay, now we lost because we can't ever recover his resolve. Because he can never recover stamina because he's being swung on every round and he doesn't have recovered directly. And this guy doesn't actually run because he has no tiles to move to. But it's still fucking bullshit. Like this, the incredible like length the AI went to block this brother. Just like runs away from zone of controls. Yeah. I don't know. Like, do we... Is there some way we can perhaps abuse that? Because... this morning has been like a string of alt F4s. And maybe that means we need to start the run again and play around with a slightly earlier recruitment schedule because we're behind on brothers right now. And like today is much harder than yesterday because we don't have any brothers to take these fights. Yeah, we did skip a couple hunter rolls very early. I mean, this is doable if we can kill the Necro. If we can't kill the Necro, it's not doable. We got a little caught out of position there. The fact that they intercept from the Necro is bullshit. Is there some way we can force them to chase brothers that we prefer them to chase, though? Like, Homie Chop running off on his own might just suck off, like, 20 of the zombies to, like, run up north because they're so... I mean, like, what if we just... it almost just advance up the middle with two flankers. If they're gonna run out of zone of control to chase down flankers every single time... Try it once more. I'm getting close to a restart though if this is gonna be because I feel like the opponents have scaled past what our brothers handle and we can't recruit new brothers with this right now. I'm kind of moving towards the restart. We'll see. So if I like run over here, and then run over here. I don't know if I can run over here with this guy. Maybe there. The only thing is, 1, 2, 3, what's rally ranged? That's rally range. Necro's up that way. One's gonna end up right there.
Oh.
go to protect the necro? Seriously? Even the geists are gonna protect the necro? The necro? This is bullshit. God, that's so much better AI than they normally play. Way better. Also, we have in melee range, right? So this is... kind of lucky, honestly. If they're going to behave like this, we can't take this, right? The whole way you take this fight is you either archer the necro down or you separate the geist and kill the geist and then brute force into the necro. If we can't do either of those things because they will adapt like this, like, then we have to come back when we have more brothers, because this is just not a thing we can do right now. Why aren't they yelling? Jesus. They're like, we only need one to break it, so we'll just use one. Well? Oh, I just stood in a fucking line for this guy to double attack through. It seems really dumb. Yell to the dog and not homie chop. It's hilarious. Now the necro can buff though. Not doable the way that this is behaving. If they always engage flankers. Yeah. Ah, oh, chat, it's looking close to a restart. We're gonna have to have archers. It just makes that archer requirement so insanely required at the beginning, like so insanely necessary, because we can't take these. And this is like the fourth fucking ult F4 of the morning, where it runs like our entire last playthrough had one ult F4. Like, do we really want to do that? I don't really want to be on that list. Maybe we could just walk past it. Maybe finish the citadel. We've got 8k. Let's try to fix this issue, I guess. I don't want to do militia. I kind of liked this start. It was interesting to me. Yeah, we could check the citadel while we're right here. Check both citadels while we're right here. I guess we have 4 days to go back, huh? Alright, what do we have floating around? There's a Friedrich the Giant. Can we, if we try him out, can we also buy him? 18, maybe? We could sell some garbage, I guess. If we have to go that route. Nope. He's a drunk, not a giant. Don't lie to me, game. He was a great axe, though, which would have been interesting. Alright. Oh, it's the western, not eastern. Oops. Okay. Spend 2k on the hedge knight that we can't use, unfortunately. It's a wildman here. Expensive. It's also a noble. Also very expensive for 5k. This guy's bad. And that guy's bad. So another 4k spent looking for nothing. Fuck chat. Keep looking for redeeming things for this run. I like the seed. Do we just need to focus hunters a little bit harder? Are we going back to fighting that first camp? Try to be a little bit more aggressive about rolling for I don't think that we need more fodder. I think we just need to be more aggressive about checking the hunter locations. Day one is what Lone Wolf's all about. Yeah. Yeah, so the pacing seems different. We gotta watch our pacing here. I think this pickup was excellent. I like this build just fine. Getting the greatsword. The greatswords might not come by again, which is too bad. We had a hedge knight hire with the greatsword, and we had a brigand leader, early brigand leader with the hedge with the greatsword, which was nice. Picking up the second hedge knight, the hedge knight was great. Even though he rolled like shit all game through. And the cell sword was kind of okay too, but again, we're finding very mediocre late game characters. We gotta get these hunters rolling. I think the fodder character that survives and becomes the dodge tank early was pretty decent. This was a fairly resilient, cheap brother to begin with. This mace is likely there again. I don't really want to change the spec for that. I mean, certainly axe spec early is not, this hasn't been helpful at all, and we've been noticing the lack of a weapon spec, but we can't get to, the problem with this build here is you can't advance into underdog and nimble without 4 points before it. And this point therefore can't be left floating till later, which is really, really annoying. I mean, if we went adrenaline with this build instead of headhunter, then maybe. I mean, headhunter is not that big of a damage increase on axes, but it is nice to have. Maybe we don't. Maybe we take rotate instead. It would be nice to have the weapon spec later for a duelist. But I want a headhunter axe. It's not the safety that we're worried about. This character, I don't know. Yes, chat, I'm aware of that. Rotate is a good perk point. Arvius goes for adrenaline. First round's max damage, sure, but I don't need to copy what Arvius does. I don't always agree with what he's doing. And B, I'm actually convinced that I want adrenaline on this build. I mean, adrenaline is nice for running down archers. Maybe that's useful enough. Like, if we're going to have so few archers of our own. Maybe you don't invest in resolve and get fortified mind. Why? My resolve has been plenty on this brother. Took us like 2 stat rolls to do it, and I don't have to take a fucking shitty perk point called Fortified Mine. That seems like a pretty nice thing not to have on my build. Why would I want to go back the other way? No, I don't mean to run down archers. You grab war dogs. No, not like run them down as they're leaving the battlefield. You end of your turn, move to a position, beginning of the turn, adrenaline past them to get past blockers to get on archers is the move we're talking about here. All right, I think we're gonna restart here. I don't think we've scaled this properly for what we have available. We may be able to just, I mean, so the question I really have, that the only question I really want to answer before we restart chat is this, is are we happy with this build here? And if not, what are we changing? This build right here. So I'm happy with the stats that came out of this in the end, and I'm happy with the nimble has been very good. It makes him very resilient to being wounded. I'm very happy with that. Picking up the early noble mail and Salat Helm have been huge. I really, really like that. It has Colossus. Please, chat, please, keep up. So the real question is, do we take Axe Mastery or something else? We have that one floating perk point. If we're gonna go duelist, we absolutely need, I'm 100% set on every part of this build that's on here, except potentially the weapon spec. For example, this mace might be here on the next run. We could spec into mace. It's a lot of stamina reduction for us. Drop axe and take cleaver with quick hands. No thanks. It's not that I don't like the whip, it's just that I don't want a brother with this much final stats being a whip brother. Like, it's just... trying one run to get gifted rotate. No. We're not going gifted on this brother. Look at his stats. Stop telling me things that don't make any sense. We had this conversation yesterday, Peter. This was your introduction to the channel, where you were telling me to take gifted on this brother. Yeah, so I don't think it's rotate either. I think this is basically adrenaline versus headhunter. Because if we take adrenaline early, we can skip the weapon spec till later. Which means that we can go this plus adrenaline, that gets us to underdog. And then it's underdog, berserk, nimble, killing frenzy, indom, duelist, or whatever else. And then we can fill the weapon spec as the floating perk point at the end. You're asking why not to learn? Sure. Because we don't need gifted on this brother. This brother has 102 fucking melee skill and 38 melee defense. We're not wasting it. We can take a much higher return perk because we don't have to fill in for stats. He's 95ing versus most of the enemies through most of the game already. And by the time his veteran levels catch up, we'll always be 95ing for the entirety of the game. There isn't a point on gifted here for most part. Rotate's incredible. This guy doesn't take it because he's too good. This is exactly true, because we're greeting that damage point here. Adrenaline's nice for killing necros? Probably not. I mean, if the necro behavior is as aggressive. I mean, did you see what the zombies were doing there? The necro was buffing a zombie who was in melee range as an attacker versus a brother he could attack. And the necro was the buff zombie was running away. This was still more than 9 tiles away from the fucking necro. There's no way my brother can get to the necro even 2 more turns, and adrenaline zombies are charging out of melee range to block that brother. Like, that's crazy. Yeah, so this is the question, right? Like, this is basically adrenaline versus headhunter here. I think headhunter's a really weird one to calculate damage increases to, right? Because its per swing damage isn't... So when a one-handed axe hits head, it does an additional 50% damage, right? Which I think is additive. So I think it goes, I think the damage mod becomes a 2.0 or a 1.5 if the enemy has steel brow. But either way, like, this is hitting heads with one-handed axes is very, very good. The question is, how much of a damage buff is headhunter? This is like a min-max thing, like where you get the max amount of it. This is the final damage perk you can take, right? If you think about this game, right, there's not shit for damage perks in here. There's a couple accuracy perks, and ignore for a second that accuracy equals damage. If you already capped on accuracy, what can you do for damage perks? And there aren't many in this game, right? There's Killing Frenzy and Berserk, which are both damage perks. This is if you kill something, you get another attack, so your damage per round goes up, although your single target damage doesn't actually increase because you can't kill something more than it's already dead. Killing Frenzy is basically the only damage perk, and this is if you've killed something recently, you get a 25% damage increase. Duelist is a damage increase if your target is armored and you're trying to do direct HP damage, which axes are pretty decent at. And other than that, there aren't any. Everything else is accuracy buffs, right? There's no other damage buff in here. This is accuracy. Executioner, I guess, is a damage buff if your target's wounded. Although wounding targets is questionable, right? Like, you kind of sometimes just want to kill them first. So this becomes the other damage buff. So I guess it's Killing Frenzy, Berserk, Adrenaline, and Headhunter are the pure damage buffs that are available. I don't know how much this is, though. Like, I did at one point math it out, and it never seemed to be all that much. I think it was like 15% or something. I don't know why that number's in my head. Probably because it's sitting right in front of me and just priming me for that number. But it wasn't a lot of extra damage, right? because you have a 25% chance to hit head, and this essentially makes what? What is that? I think you could look at it. I think I ended up looking at that as like an average across like five swings, because it goes 25, 40, 55, 70, 85, 100, right? Is your chances, is that right? So it's 25, 40, 55, 70, 85, 100. So it's every six swings, you're guaranteed a headshot. So with Headhunter, so basically it's 50% extra damage over six, is that right? Can't you put adrenaline into damage burst, not increase? Sure, but that's not a damage increase, that's burst damage. Like, you kind of answer it in your own question. Yeah, it was a very, I remember when I, because I originally had that on the spreadsheet, Y-O-E-N, and I was trying to, because I wanted to ask, basically, answer the question, how much did Headhunter help? And it seemed to help, like, basically super shit damage for everything. Yeah, I'd love to know. I'd love to know how much Headhunter helps versus targets. So here's a couple of things that go with that that make this even harder to model, right? Like, figuring out the model that works for this is super challenging. I think late game, what we want to have is we want to have a number of weapons that have armor penetration. Like, the fighting versus chosen in the last campaign really kind of highlighted for me how valuable weapons that do direct HP damage can be, even when you're not trying to always kill them before their armor goes out. So if you have a bunch of brothers with a bunch of different ways to do direct HP damage, you often end up killing things faster than you would kill them otherwise, which is kind of funny. So, like, I don't know. Like, I guess I'm looking at, ultimately what I'm looking at is how quickly do I one or two shot raiders? I mean, yeah, I guess you could just model some armor values. Like, I don't know. I don't know the exact answer to that I don't know the exact way to model it, or I've done it myself, right? Like, what is the best way to calculate this? I guess I want to know what percentage damage increase Headhunter actually represents. Like, is it a 20% damage increase, a 5% damage increase, a 1% damage increase? I remember it being terrible for all weapons except one-handed axes when I looked at that. Yes, Beowulf, I did. Yeah, you can't take Underdog out, chat. Like, there's just so many things wrong with taking out Underdog. It's such a huge accuracy penalty or accuracy boost to the enemies. You don't need to model it so much as sim a fight 1 million times. Just need the weapon damage, armor, and HP values. Okay, well, the weapon damage you can pull out of the spreadsheet, right? That has one hand. Just take a one-handed fighting axe, and then I guess sim it versus... I'm kind of interested in, I guess, probably Chosen is probably the best way to do it. Chosen are a pretty nice mix. Like, Chosen and Raiders are really similar in terms of... Chosen are, like, tankier Raiders, and I think what we're looking for is I want to be able to just, like, wade in. If we, especially in this, like, this type of playthrough, I want to be able to wade in and just fucking annihilate humanoid targets. I don't know what Chosen armor is about. About 200 is fine, something like that, so... Okay, I need a quick break, chat, though. I'm going to make food. This is my food break. We are going to restart. And when I come back, I would like I'm going to put a poll up on this. I'm going to let you guys decide about this. So I don't think Adrenaline's where I want to be on here. I think I want to try the Sweet Headhunter build, but we can still, or the Sweet Axe Brother build, but we can still do Adrenaline and Axe if we don't take Headhunter. So really it becomes how good is Headhunter, and maybe YOEN can run that simulation. We can have some sense of it, and we can make a decision, because it would make leveling easier. Kind of, because we don't have to take Axe Mastery early and we get Adrenaline, which is super nice for the early game. So I'll throw it up as a poll, but I'm not entirely certain is the answer. I would love to see, think how great this guy's going to be late game, right? So we already survived to the mid game here, and we ran into mid game issues. The mid game issue was not the build on this brother. This brother is still carrying the fight super hard, right? The mid game issues we ran into were no archers. So if we get to the mid game next playthrough, when we're going to start in a second here, if this guy makes it to an orc famed axe, for example, like, all bets are fucking off. If you guys thought the cleavers from last playthrough were good, wait till you fucking see famed axes, like famed orc axes hitting things. It's hilarious. They just explode. And like, I want to see that again. It's been so many playthroughs now. It's probably been six playthroughs since I've had the last good axe duelist. And you need this like magic congruence of like traits to happen. You need a shit ton of stamina. You need a shit ton of accuracy. And you need a brother with the perk points to do it. And we can do that. This brother's guaranteed a shit ton of stamina and guaranteed a shit ton of accuracy. and he's guaranteed to have this. By the time we ever get an axe, we're already going to have this brother, because his brother's going to be all the way through with this. And we don't need him early spec'd in a different way. We don't have to have him spec'd somewhere else to carry through this playthrough. So for me, like, I want to go axe. There's no way I'm not going axe on there. The question is, do we do adrenaline or headhunter? And I guess the way to decide that is how good is headhunter. So, nah, I don't think names are going back on the roster, Xanabu. These people have had playtime. We've had playtime. I think it's these guys die. And we will carry on with the next one in a minute. And I think we're gonna name this. I didn't enjoy yelling at myself. Not because I care about yelling at myself, but just like I like this to be a viewer. I like to be able to, like, this is, you know, Homie Chop's day to shine, or Xanabu's day to shine, or whatever else. So I think we're gonna do that. Okay, I'm gonna take that break now. I'm gonna leave the poll up and we'll see. So, and we're gonna do the seed again. I really like the seed. All right, how do I make this clear? I'm gonna leave this up so you guys can see the build. And I think Arvius has a huge blind spot, by the way, for duelists. He hasn't used them enough. He just hasn't seen powerful duelists. So you guys, I've done it in other playthroughs. You guys will see it. It's an amazing, amazing fucking build late game. So it's adrenaline versus headhunter. And you guys can vote, but I think what we're really, I'm curious to see what you guys have. You can think about it and try to think of justifications one way or the other. But what I'm really interested in seeing is the data that suggests why one would be better than the other, so we can make a bit more of an informed decision. I think adrenaline gives a flexibility to the character that Headhunter won't, where Headhunter's pure damage. And there is something to be said about that flexibility, but I'm not sure it's good enough. We'll see. We'll see. Anyways, guys, I'm going to take that break. I'll be about 5 minutes as I cook food and come back. And then we'll start the next playthrough of Lone Wolf on this seed. We have to get our archers going sooner. There's enough hunters' cabins on this map. That's just on us. We need to prioritize that earlier than we did. And then, anyways, back in a few, guys. See you shortly. All right, chat. What do we have? Okay, guess I'm looking to see if we have any sort of take home. Journaling gives you so much more damage flexibility. Let's think through again, chat. Again, like Iowan, I'm looking at you specifically on this one, right? Like, if there's only two damage perks in the game and damage perks are super valuable, which is both those things are true. And Headhunter is a situational damage perk that only applies to one weapon system, which is the one-handed axe, which is true. Adrenaline gives you so much more flexibility. This is just a damage perk. It's not like you're ever considering taking this. You're never going to be taking Killing Frenzy instead of Adrenaline, ever. You're always taking Killing Frenzy, right? So, like, you wouldn't make that same decision. And you don't know how much damage Headhunter is because you haven't done the math and you haven't seen take home on this, right? So I hate that. I hate that it's so quick for that, right? Like, you don't know what this is worth, but you're immediately saying this is better than that, and Adrenaline is better than just a damage perk. Just a damage perk is Berserk and Killing Frenzy in this game. Just the damage perk is literally the must-required for every single late-game damage dealer, be it Archer, Frontliner, or Polearm Brother. Like, just the damage perk in this game? There's two of them. I don't know, man. Show me late game builds that don't use Berserk and Killing Frenzy. For 1,000 hits, Headhunter makes you hit 400 to 430 headshots. Alright, so what is that then? That's 25 over 43 for... What's the actual increase in number of headshots? Because you hit 25 without it, right? Well... No. I don't. It's not that I want to try Headhunter or not. It's that I want to understand how Headhunter is in terms of damage. I mean, this is a 25 dam. This is a 25% damage perk that's not active all the time. That is basically considered. This basically is a must-have on every brother for the late game, right? Like, no one's debating that. If Headhunter is comparable in damage with that one-handed axe, then the argument stays the same. Then this becomes basically unavoidable. But it's really, really hard to quantify how much extra damage Headhunter is, for me anyways. So I guess having outsourcing that quantification to somebody else who's better at this and to tell me what that's worth is interesting to me. Because then I can assign a value to it. How much damage is Headhunter? Someone just told me that in a simulation of 1,000 hits or 1,000 attacks, you get 430 were headshots with Headhunter. 430, the base is 250, right, out of 1,000? So this is the increase from 250. So what is that? It's, you know, it's 25% to 43% is 23 times X equals 43. So it's 43 over 25. So 43 over 25 is a what percentage increase? Is a, no, it's not right. You're trying to do math on armor reduction of armor pieces too. It's hard to quantify how much that helps or hurts. I agree. Except with the axe that you can though. If you look at we man, I agree. Complicated, right? Probably the Battle Brother Discord is where you want to do that Z-Drift. So my Discord, but the Battle Brothers channel for that. Yeah, I mean, we don't have to wait around for this because we can answer that. We don't have to have that build answered immediately, although we will want that build answered eventually. But I am curious because I don't know the answer to that. And this is a question that actually probably would be a nice one to have answered for the Battle Brothers community as a whole, because in general, Headhunter is one of these perks that nobody ever takes. Nobody ever takes it because it's a shitty perk. The only weapon system that actually benefits from this at all, as best as I can tell, is the one-handed axe. And that's because the one-handed axe has a 50% damage bonus, which, by the way, I don't know if it's additive or multiplicative. I think it's additive for a one-handed axe when it hits head. Most of the time, hitting head for 25% sucks because it breaks your damage. It spreads your damage between body and head. And most of the enemies in the game fucking have steel brow anyways. So like most of the time, you're not even getting a damage boost for hitting head. You're just spreading out shitty damage across the body. And the head crit damage, I don't know about the axe crit damage. I think the axe crit damage is 50% extra, but the actual critical damage that you do from hitting the head is only body damage. It's only health damage directly. It's not even armor damage, which makes most of the time, that makes that absolutely terrible to be hitting the head. So it would be sweet if this perk was actually a perk you could utilize with a weapon system designed to hit heads, one-handed axes, to do damage. It is hilarious when you one-shot shit by hitting things with a great axe in the head, but I don't really know the great way to quantify that. So I've struggled with this for years, a year, thinking about Headhunter and kind of on and off been like, I don't know, man. So it's really kind of tough to say. Kind of need to know if it's additive or multiplicative. Well, you're the guy with the access to the gold, man. I think it's additive, but I don't know. Just try it. It's been great, but what does it mean? What is good and great? You like see a guy there. Okay, doesn't matter. We're going to restart the seed. Do we have the BB seed, right? So I don't mean to shit on you, I1, for that, but it just seems like to me, like, I hate it when it comes as simple as, like, it's just the damage perk. Well, yeah, but in this game, there's, like, two damage perks. All right, let's retire this run. So this run is rip.